Texas Tech head football coach Matt Wells with us, Sikkim 365 Radio. We've heard this from every coach, but is it nice just to be back to somewhat normalcy with this?
It is. There's no question about it. I think sometimes you appreciate what you had when you lose it. You know, we all lost it. We lost face-to-face contact. We lost not just media days, but just in-person, personality, personable. It just was so stale. You know, it was behind a screen and behind a computer. And I think there was some good that came out of it. Of it all, but there's no question. I think everybody's excited. You don't have a mask on anymore, and we can do stuff in person.
How much did – I mean, year two is usually when you can kind of work things out, you know, what didn't work in year one and all that. But you had such a weird year two. Everybody had such a weird year two or year two. Is this really kind of where you would see yourself at year two normally?
It feels like year two.
Yeah.
It really does. And I recognize and realize that everybody – dealt with COVID in college football. But for us, going into year two, because we were drastically changing everything that they had, you know, whether it was the weight room, how you go to class, the discipline, the accountability. And the first year, we just had to start at ground zero. And then you go into year two, and you're really ready to start making some progress in terms of those things. And then COVID hits. And so for us, it does feel like year two, because it is only our second year in real off seasons and real summers in terms of that. Last year, I mean, our guys didn't even come back till the middle or the end of June, and then it was like individual workouts, and then you know, stretches of August where we were down in the mid-50s. Mm-hmm. For a few practices in about a week in August. I mean, how in the world do you do all that? And so we fought through it. But, yeah, it hit our program at a tough time. But I'm thankful for where we're at right now. And we're in a better spot than we've ever been, I know, since we've been there.
What do you want the personality to be of your football team?
Tough, accountable. A team that, you know, an opposing coaching staff or opposing team says, well, they don't hand you anything. Mm-hmm. They don't give you anything. They make you go the long, hard way, and they're tough. And, man, those guys are blue-collar. They're tough. Now, we got some skill, and we got guys that can do things with ball in their hand. And but at the end of the day, you want a toughness and accountability and a discipline to be at the forefront of your program.
The Big 12 for a long time, not that there weren't teams that were tough or whatever, but for a long time it was known as the opposite, or at least it was the high-flying conference. Do you see that changing now with Dave, you, Coach Klieman, what he's going to do, try to do at Kansas State, what Matt Campbell's done, among others?
Well, you may not see as many, 50-something to 50-something type games. You know, we've certainly been in a couple of them. But I don't think the defensive guys, coaches, I don't think the defensive players get enough credit in this league. And I've talked about it a lot today from Dave. And Dave and I go way back.
Mm-hmm.
You know, Gary Patterson, Jim Knowles at Oklahoma State, Alex Grinch at OU, Heacock at Iowa State. These guys, they can coach defense. They're good. And these defenses are now making you go the long, hard way. And, you know, the old adage of bend, don't break, I don't buy that. But, man, it's a challenge every week. And you know, maybe before it was 50-something to 50-something, balls flying everywhere. But don't get me wrong, there's enough offensive firepower in this league. You can have some scores like that real quick mm-hmm. if somebody's not playing very well on defense.
How much is the transfer portal, now that you know what it really is and you have the rule of the one-time transfer, how much has that helped you guys, especially in this, what is your, you know, now real year two, kind of help reset your roster the way you
want? It's going to help us be competitive now.
Mm-hmm.
No question about it. I mean, the numbers and the holes that we had to replace from 2 years ago in terms of that program and the recruiting and where the scholarship numbers, the only way we could do it is through the portal. And our initial game plan was to get old mm-hmm. and go through the graduate transfer mm-hmm. Process and then sign, you know, as good as we can, elite Texas high school, mainly a few from Oklahoma talent, but you got to sprinkle that in with the transfers. And now it's just expanded. It's not grad transfers. We got three. But, I mean, we're taking three-year sophomores. Some kids have 4 years left. And so those are guys, too, from my standpoint at Texas Tech, that some of those guys we couldn't have touched. They weren't interested in Texas Tech 2019 when we first got there.
You know, it used to be, and that's because I'm older, but you had to go junior college to try to get older quicker. That's right. Kind of the only way. Now, that's you got all sorts of different angles.
There's not much difference.
Yeah.
I mean, what's the difference between taking a junior college guy and a transfer that's a junior right
mm-hmm.
now? Zero.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing. And so that's why it hadn't really, I don't think, quite affected college coaches as much as people think.
How much more, though, is coaching the X's and O's and all of that? But you have so many things that have happened with the NIL now, and then the transfer portal, and then, of course, COVID. Has it made it more difficult to be a head coach?
Certainly changed. It certainly made it be difficult. You know, I don't know any other way, though, in the Big 12 since I've been here, because COVID hit pretty quick.
Yeah.
And you have those three big things, NIL, transfers, and COVID. But, yeah, I do think, and it's, you know, the NIL is good, in my opinion. I don't think I'm in the minority in that. I do think it's good, but I think it creates a lot of responsibility for your players. And I think that can be very healthy, and I can go at length if y'all want to talk about that more. But the transfer portal has been very good to Texas Tech. And so it's things that you learn as a head coach to navigate and manage a roster.
About making the NIL, doing it a healthy way. Obviously, there's probably going to be some guys that's going to be their focus once they get their first deal, you know, because they're not mature enough to handle it. On you as a coach to navigate that, is that just maybe about building maturity and education in the team?
Yeah, absolutely. You need to educate. We need to do what we can as each university to help educate and to help promote, give them chances to promote their name and likeness or brand, if you will. But the responsibility piece that I alluded to, I think it's, you know, it goes on that player. And so there's a responsibility with a deal or an endorsement or a commercial or whatever they have. And there's bigger responsibilities, and it could come in the form of taxes, contract lawyers, marketing agencies. Am I going to pay them? You know, those are, you know, do I want them to help? Well, then I owe some money. And there's a big responsibility there. But on the other side of that is an individual's responsibility, the way I look at it, to protect his own brand and name. And what is that? Well, you better be working out, and you better be training the right way, and you got to play well. And the more time and investment that they spend in extra needs and eating right and sleeping right and training right to play good will help this other hand. And so I believe there's a certain positivity with both of those if it's done within a team atmosphere. And if you're respect and care for your teammates by virtue and by way of your individual self improving and your teammates can see that, I think you have a chance for the whole thing to work together.
The game with Baylor last year, which was a bizarre game, and you win the game
at the
buzzer.
2 years?
Yeah, well, no. I don't. The butt fumble.
You called it that.
Whatever it was. But you lost that one in 19, and Matt had a team that ends up playing for a Big 12 title. Then
great
last
team.
Year, a hell of a team.
Really good.
But they had to win like four of those type games, buzzer beaters. And you won, and you've lost some of those. Did you feel like turning the corner, beating Baylor the way you did that give them a little bit of that incentive of knowing that's really, in the end, what really dictates a season?
It does, and I talked about that earlier. You know, my first year, we went 0-4 in one-score games, Baylor being one of them,
uh-huh.
right, down in Waco. Last year, we went 4-2. Baylor was a win. Kansas was a win. West Virginia was a win. We lost, you know, by 6 at the end to Oklahoma State and Texas in overtime and had them down and lost. So, you know, that's, I think, as your players go through those fires – and they lose some and they win some. The winning, you know, they start to gain some confidence in that. But any team, you'll look back at the end of the year, I can just say this, and I'm not in the prediction business, but you look back and you're going to say, who won the close games? They're going to be a winning record. They're going to be in a bowl, okay? And who won one or two more that were one-score games? They're going to have 7, 8, 9 wins.
Mm-hmm.
Those are the teams that they're going to win. They're win games. And every Saturday's a battle in this league, and you have to find ways to win close games. And when you win some, like you mentioned, the Baylor game last year, the Kansas game, and, you know, we didn't play very good, but you found a way to win, you start to gain a confidence.
How good a coach is he, Dave? You've known him a while.
Yeah. We go way back, 2012. You know, we were coordinators together at Utah State.
Right.
That was a great year. We went 11-2. We were really good on both sides of the ball. It was fun. It was a fun year. You know, Dave is extremely intelligent, deep thinker, would come into my office and grab the marker, go to the board. First of all, those defensive guys, they draw everything upside down. And he would go to the board and he'd draw a blitz or a pressure package, a pressure, and he'd say, he'd give me the pen and say, block it. Protect it. Protect your quarterback. And I do it, and he'd say, what if I do this? And I'm like, then they would do this. And then what if I did this? Well, it's really good, Dave. That's going to be a sack. You know, it's going to be a strip sack. Go Utah State, right? go get him, Miranda. But I think he's ahead of his time. I think he was ahead of his time back then. We competed against him when he was at Hawaii, and then he came and joined us at Utah State. Like I said, great year together. We had really good memories. Our wives are friends. They still are. Dion and Jen are both friends, still good friends. And so good friend of mine, really good coach. I wish he was in another league, to be honest with you.
Well, your wife's a Baylor grad, right?
She is.
Yeah.
So, I was wondering if y'all knew that or not.
So how do you – I mean, you've played two very close games with them. So how do you navigate – I mean, obviously she wants you to win, but, like, she went to Baylor for four years. Yeah.
Well, I can tell you, she used to tell Matt Rule every time she'd see Matt, she'd say, Matt, I hope you go 11-1.
Yeah.
Hope you go 11-1.
Yeah. Yeah. And
with the one loss to Texas Tech, right?
Yep. Yep.
And so, unfortunately, I'm 0-1 against Matt. She's a Baylor grad. She's a Baylor fan. And she was a fan of Matt Rule. We knew Matt when I was at Utah State when he first got the job. And obviously now with Dave being at Baylor, it's I think it's easier for her to cheer for them, you know, inside the house, not outside the house. But I can tell you this, that girl is scarlet and black. I mean, she's Texas Tech, and tremendous support for me. There's not a better coach's wife out there.
It's good to see you, man. It's good to see all of this, and it leads to whatever else we have coming up, which is football. Thank goodness.
That's a really good player right there in the green suit. Did y'all interview him?
He's awfully special. They missed him when he was out too, man.
I didn't miss him.
That's right.
He's a really good player. Dave can sit him out when we come down there on Thanksgiving too if he wants.
When he gets to somebody and tackles him, it's like a can opener. It's like,
he's
that.
Really good. He's one of the best in the league.
Thanks, Matt. Appreciate it.
Appreciate y'all
Texas Tech head football coach Matt Wells on Sikkim 365 Radio.